Good evening, friends. My name is Shailendra Kumar Singh. In the previous video, we have read about the transistor biasing. Why transistor biasing is important to get the faithful amplifications, and which is a very essential to design any kind of electronic circuits. Now we will focus on the single stage transistor amplifiers. What is the single stage? Before our focus has to solve the some objective questions, but before solving some objective questions, we have to know some theoretical backgrounds. So let us start our review. Within 10 minutes to 15 minutes, we will cover all the theoretical backgrounds, which are very, very important for any competitive examinations, particularly technical officer, senior technical, or technical assistants for the electronic science needs, IGCAR, BARC, and all PSC, state level PSC examinations. So we will review this chapter, and then after we will go for the solving the questions. If you like my video, please just subscribe and share with your friends. And it gives a boost and energy to me to make another video. I will bring some very wonderful, and I will always share some good video so that you can also enjoy. And I will also help you apart from the exam, in which exam you are eligible for your career point of view, and how to solve the questions. Okay, let us start. This transistor, this is the single state transistor amplifiers. If you instance, you just read these things. For instance, radio receiver amplifier, very big signal, sometimes a very few millionth of a volt at antenna until they are strong enough to fill a room with sounds. The transducer used to in the medical and scientific investigation generate signals in the microvolt and millivolt range. These signal stages must be amplified thousands and millions times before they are strong enough to operate indicating instruments. You see, what is the amplification? How much thousand times? Suppose we are giving the antenna is receiving like a millionth of a volt, like what we consider one volt, but a millionth of the volt, like less than 10 parts of the 10 lakh, how it is a minimum volt, but despite of receiving such type of minimum volt, they are able to receive the catching the signal. So amplifier is very, very essential. Amplifier also able to enhance the like a thousand times of the signals. So it is a amplifier is a very, very essential. So how we will, our purpose here to will discuss a single stage amplifier. By stage, we mean a single transistor with the bias and auxiliary equipment. You remember this line, because this line is one question is there. If you look at what is the single transistor and auxiliary equipment is required to develop any kind of single state transistor. It may be emphasized here that a practical amplifier is always a multi-stage amplifier. It has a number of stages for amplification. Theoretically, we are studying single stage amplifier, but if you go into the practical applications, it is very difficult. We use a multi-stage amplifiers because it is quite impossible to develop only a single stage. So they are single stage amplifiers when only one transistor with associated circuitry is used for amplifying a weak signal. The circuit is known as single amplifier. This is the circuit. You see, this is the circuit of the single amplifier. You see, this is DCC, voltage divider circuit is there. A single stage transistor has one transistor bias, other auxiliary components. Okay, thus the practical circuit of a transistor amplifier. This is a biasing circuit, input. You see, this is the auxiliary components. Earlier, what we are only we are thinking about the biasing, but you see here three kind of resistance capacitor they are also using. First one, the input capacitance, emitter capacitance. This is the coupling capacitance, and according coupling, we also connect one load resistance is there. Then such type of auxiliary elements is also required to develop any kind of single stage amplifier. What is the utility of all the capacitance one by one? We will understand then after we go for the next. practical circuit of a transistor amplifier, the resistor R1, R2, and RE from the biasing in a stabilization circuit. The biasing circuit must establish a proper operating point, otherwise it part of negative half cycles. Input capacitance. An electrolytic capacitor C input 10 microfarad is used to couple the signal to the base of a transistor. If it is not used signal sources, a resistor will come across R2 and thus change the biasing. The capacitor C in allow only AC signal to flow, but isolate the signal from R2. Suppose if you are not, what is the utility of capacitance to charging, to take the charging? Suppose if we are supplying the current, higher current, and it will be go into this, and it affects our biasing. So here, if some more voltage will come, it will come and charging this capacitor. So C input is very essential, and it also always allow AC signal. This AC will be charged here, and so it also able to protect the biasing circuit. Second one is that its value is the input capacitance 10 microfarad. This is known as electrolytic capacitance. Second one is the capacitance, emitter bypass capacitor. An emitter bypass capacitance CE 100 microfarad is used in practical in parallel with the RE to provide a low reactance power to the amplified AC signal. It is not used, then amplified AC signal flowing RE will cause a voltage drop in it. Suppose if you are not using this emitter capacitance, some more voltage, this is the high resistance, its value is the around 5 to 1000 ohm is there meter resistance. If we are using high resistance of the, then we find that some old voltage drop here, and we will receive the low voltage gain here, power gain. So to avoid such type of problems, we generally connect the meter capacitance. So it parallel, it some currents will go and charging this capacitance, and it will not disturb these circuits. So we use the 10 times of the electrolytic capacitor of the C value 10 times to electrolytic capacitor. Third one is that third capacitor is that coupling capacitor. The coupling capacitance CC 10 microfarad couples one stage of amplifier amplification of the next. If it is not used, the bias condition of the next will drastically change due to the shunting effect of RC. This is because RC will come in parallel with the upper resistance R1 of the biasing network of the next stage, thereby altering the biasing conditions of the latter. In short, the coupling capacitor CC isolates the DC of one stage from the next stage, but allow only AC. It here also comes one shunting effect. They are saying that if you are not using the coupling capacitance here, shunting, it are connected in the parallel, R1 and RC are connected in the parallel. So it will also affect the shunting effects. They will suffer, and it also disturb the biasing of the collector emitter circuits. So to avoid the this biasing into the collector emitter regions, we supply the coupling capacitance, and in coupling capacitance of load resistance is also connected. Load resistance is connected to protect the this transistor, because if some more current will come, this load resistance will receive the some, and it gives into the ground stage. So it also helps to protect the transistor, because if you look at the higher voltage some comes, maybe that damage. So this also helps to protect the transistor. Okay, let us move on next part. So we will you see the phase is very clear. We also read in the phase difference of 180 degree between the signal voltage of the output was in the common emitter amplifier in one edge phase reversal. Next one, yeah, this is very, very important. If you see, if you see all the three lines, ये very important regarding for every amplifiers CE, CP and CC the input and output are in phase when the input current decreases the output also decreases in bias versa. Remember that CE circuit is only configured that as input and output 180 for both CP and CC the input and output voltage are in phase if input voltage decreases the output voltage also decreases in bias versa. Okay. Next one is the very important how to find out the DC and AC equivalent circuits. This is the VDV voltage. This is the single stage transistor. You can say, and they are using the voltage divider circuits to get the there to solving such type of questions. Generally, we assume to simplify the circuits. We generally takes the two circuits. First one is that DC circuits. The second one is the AC circuits. And how we will get the DC value, how we will get the AC value separately. And these are the very important to practical point of view for development of any circuits. One by one, we will understand what is the DC. If you want to calculate the DC current, DC collector current, DC in base currents, all the things, initially you have to convert the DC equivalent circuit. And for converting DC equivalent circuits, you have to remove all the AC sources. All the AC sources you will receive, and all the AC sources you have to remove and open all the capacitors. Because for the DC analysis, AC is just like a open circuits. To want to get the DC, just you remove this one. This is a ribbon because this is the AC signal. This is the also AC AC capacitance. This is also AC part. This is also part. Just simply becomes like a voltage. What earlier we are studying in the transistor biasing chapter, just it becomes like a voltage divider. Simple, only biasing is there, nothing else. Only biasing is there. So, in the case of to get the DC biasing, we have to make sure that all the capacitor is open and AC is open. Then we will get. Very simple, if you can say such type of circuits will get. And for if you want to second one, if you want to the AC equivalent circuit, what will see, you have to make sure that all the capacitance should be short circuit to get the AC signal short circuit, because otherwise how will understand. So then what will be, this will be short circuit will be there, this will the short circuit there, this is also a short circuit will be there. And you have to remove only the VCC, what is the DC voltage, you have to remove this part, what we are supplying earlier, VCC, you have to remove this one, okay. So let us go into the next one. And then this is the AC equivalent circuits you see, this is the AC equivalent circuit, this is AC signal, this is R1, R2 ground, they are putting the base currents, so this is emitter current, this is a collector current, RC and RL, the collector, this is the AC equivalent circuits of the single stage transistor. Earlier, this is the DC equivalent circuit of the single stage transistors. Okay, then we will also consider how much resistance you are observing, how much resistance is observing after DC. Suppose this is the short, if this is the short, which kind of resistance you will observe? You will observe here capacitance resistance, sorry, RC, the RC resistance and RE resistance, you will observe. So such type of question also asked in the examinations, when you are following the DC equivalent circuit, AC equivalent, big kind of resistance you will see, yeah, observe. And such type of things is essential to develop the practical circuits. Load line analysis. DC load line, it is the line of the output characteristic of a transistor which gives the value of IC and DC corresponding to zero signal or DC conditions. Okay. Let us move. AC load line, this is the line of the output character of transistor which gives the value of IC and DC. Let us move. You see the DC load line, AC load line. The slope of the AC load line is more compared to DC load lines, and it is more steeper compared to DC load lines. So just remember at the point of time, because see which is the slope is higher compared to DC load lines. voltage, the basic function of amplifier to raise the oscillator. This the EEG problem we have also seen in the earlier. This is the diode resistance. How we'll find, we also know 26 millivolt. Voltage gain of C amplifier, remember RAC. This is the just practical things that how we find the voltage gain, how the power gain, like that. You have to see a lot of things is there, but our examination of point where thus you have to understand and go. The capacitor C actually sorts of AC signals. So let us move into the our some questions sections, so that we can spend some more time. So where just theoretically we have observed which is important, which is not important. So let us at the point of time, let us move into the some questions part. So let us, yeah. A single stage amplifier contains DAS and associated circuitry. What we see, one transistor is required. To develop one transistor. The phase between the and the other associated circuitry, what is associated? C in electrolytic capacitor, its value is the 10 microfarad, and CC is a coupling capacitance, its value is also 10 microfarad. Means C in and CC both are same, and third one is the auxiliary circuit, third one is the emitter capacitance, its value is 100 microfarad. And apart from this, we have to also connect the load resistance, and we have to supply the AC current into the biasing circuits. So biasing, particularly in the base emitter regions, we have to supply. So this is auxiliary circuit, you can say. The phase difference between an output and input of a C amplifier, we know very several times, 180 degrees. It is generally designed to amplifier should have less input impedance. It is generally desired of a transistor should have less input. The input very high should be required. It is desired. When an AC signal is applied to an amplifier, the operating point moves along with the AC load line. When AC signal is applied to the amplifier, the operating point moves along the AC load line. The collector supply is 10 volt. The collector cutoff voltage under DC conditions is dash volt. Also, it will be the collector supply is 10 volt and collector cutoff voltage of DC condition also it will be same. This will be 10 volt. In the zero signal conditions, the transistor sees dash load line. Then first one is the DC load line. Is the theoretical question in zero signal condition a transistor C dash load line? The input capacitor in an amplifier is the dash electrolytic capacitor. The input capacitor is the dash capacitor bypass leakage. 7 is the first one. The input capacitor in an amplifier is the dash capacitor. If you use the electrolytic capacitor is there, but here we can say the bypass capacitor is nothing. You can say coupling capacitor also used to protect the biasing in the secondary parts, particularly collector and emitter. The point of intersection of DC and AC load lines is called operating points. It's very easy questions we also read in the earlier part. The slope of AC load line is dash is the more than what just we read a few minutes ago. If a transistor amplifier draw 2 milliampere when input voltage is 2 volt, then input impedance will be, just you multiply both one, then what you will get? 20 kilo ohm. You will get 20 kilo ohm. When transistor amplifier is operating, the current in any branch is, when transistor is this 11, when transistor amplifier is operating, the current in any branch is, the current is any branch is the sum of the AC and DC currents. The purpose of capacitor is in a transistor amplifier is to protect the transistor, hold the transistor properly, bypass the, because it always used for the bypass a couple. In the DC equivalent circuit of a transistor amplifier, the capacitors are what will be here open. In a C amplifier, the voltage gain is equal to RC, RAC by R. Just if you see, this is the question is given in the theoretical parts. If you go into the theoretical parts, you will get this is the beta will be, amplifier gain will be ready-made question in there. In practice, the voltage gain of an amplifier is expressed in the decibel. Always voltage gain, power gain, and decibel is there. If the power and current gains of a transistor and amplifier is 16,500 and 100 respectively, the voltage gain is equal to power gain divided by this part. What is the current gains means you will get 165. RC and RL of the collector resistance and load resistance respectively in a single state transistor, the AC load line is the AC load line. What will be the AC load line will be just a parallel to the RC and RL. Why is such type of theoretical question? You have to analyze the AC load line and DC load lines, because AC load line and DC load line only we can see if you remove the signal, if you remove the auxiliary elements, then we can realize in C amplifier the phase difference between the voltage and the collector RC signal is there. Here option is given 0 degree, but till now I didn't know what the reason why they are claiming 0 degree. So it is better not to pick out here what is the here option. They are giving the 0 degree, but I don't know why they are claiming 0 degree. But for this time, just you see for examination, it comes you can take out here collector RC and signal 0 degree, but. In the AC equivalent circuit of a transistor amplifier, the capacitors are, what will be capacitor? For the AC, it will be always short. You see, no, in AC, it will be short always. Yeah. In a single stage transistor, RC and RL represents the collector resistance and load resistance respectively. There are transistor C, a DC load off. DC load off means RC. Here such type of questions is not easy to solve, because we have to realize the circuits. We just you, I request you, I just go to AC and DC load lines to solve these questions, and you try to solve this. If you not solve, I will help you regarding solving these circuits. The purpose of a DC conditions in a transistor is to reverse bias the emitter, forward bias. The purpose of DC condition in transistor, reverse bias the emitter, forward bias the collector, set up the operating point. Third one is the right option, set up the operating points. So DC condition we use. The amplifier has the power gain of 100. It's a DC. What is a DC? 20 log of 100 means you will get log 100 means 2. 20 into 2, 20 decibel. In order to get more voltage gain from a transistor amplifier, the transistor should have thin base. Yeah, it is very important. To achieve the this question also we read in the previous video. The purpose of a coupling capacitor in transistor amplifier is to increase the output impedance of the transistor, protect the transistor, pass AC and block DC, providing biasing. Then it's pass AC and block DC. Always this is the vital for any kinds of circuits. Capacitor always acts pass AC and block DC. The purpose of the emitter capacitor capacitance across RE is to avoid voltage drop, forward bias emitter, reduce the noise in the amplifier. This is avoid voltage drop, voltage gain drop. Then the option will be first, avoid voltage gain drop across emitter resistance. The ratio of the output to input impedance of a C amplifier is. C amplifier, if you look at the is the moderate, this is the moderate will be, and high it will be moderate in the case of C amplifier. If a transistor amplifier fits a load of low resistance, example a speaker, then voltage gain will be sometimes we also observe so many sound boxing, the DJ and all the party they are conducting. Then we find the voltage, they are not able to raise the signals. It is because of they decrease the voltage suddenly. Voltage gain will be low. Voltage gain will be low. 27 means voltage will be fourth option is the right option. If the input capacitance of a transistor amplifier is short circuited, then transistor, if the input capacitance will be short circuited, then transistor will destroy, biasing condition will change, a signal will not reach the base. Signal will not reach the base. This is the right option. Signal will not. If you just if input of a transistor amplifier is short circuited, then signal will not reach. The radio wave pickup by receiving antenna is amplified about dash times. Originator signals, then how much is that? 1 million. 1 million means around 10 lakh. The C amplifier is used, dash the circuit. Grounded emitter, grounded base, C amplifier. This is the grounded emitter will be 30 ka, 30 ka. DC load of a transistor amplifier is generally dash that of the AC load. The DC load of a transistor amplifier is generally dash of the AC load. The right option is the more than AC load. The value of collector RC in transistor is dash the output impedance of the transistor. The value of collector load RC in transistor amplifier is dash the output impedance of the transistor. Then right option less than collector resistance will be less than. In a single stage amplifier, which collector load RC and emitter RE has a DC load of a single stage amplifier with the collector load RC and emitter RC has a DC load of 33.4 RC plus R. Such type of things I will again I request you please go to the circuits. If you are not, I will also spend some more time to solve these circuits. If you say DC and AC, so it is easy. Such type of theory we can always say that understand that if you solve the question, solve the circuits. In a transistor capacitor, we generally use electrolytic capacitor. Yeah, electrolytic, its value is around 10 microfarad. A single state transistor amplifier with no load, C and AC load of. This is the, again, this is the some theoretical lesson. Again, this is the, I will not suggest to remember this circuit. I will make, if you see, I will make some video regarding DC and AC analysis of the separately, so that each is such an objective questions we can always solve, we can solve only if you solve some more practical circuits. Otherwise, it is difficult for anyone. Yeah, the output power of a transistor amplifier is more than the input power because the additional power is supplied by the collector supply VCC. The output of power of transistor is supplied by the input of power because the additional power supply collector. A transistor converts, we know it is a very popular DC to AC. So right first on the right option, a transistor amplifier has the high output impedance because emitter is heavily doped, transistor amplifier high output emitter is heavily collector has a reverse bias, collector is wider than emitter bias, none of the above. The right option is the collector has a reverse biasing. Power gain highest in the CC. CC is the highest power gain. CC continues used for impedance matching because of input impedance is very high. Yes, it is the right option. Input impedance is very high. Friends, we have covered today. This is the answer. You can also see this. All the answer is given. No problem. You can also check out. And thank you very much for your listening. If you like, please subscribe my channel. Thank you very much for your kind attentions. Thank you. Thank you very much.